Thank you very much, guys. We've already crowned one champion in the juniors division. So moving on, we've got to crown another one, this time in the seniors division. Guys, give it up for our players going to be taking the stage for the final. Christopher Hahn and Thiago Pimentel. Looking forward to a fantastic game from both of you gents. If you could slide on over to the table and we can get this match started very, very shortly.
Of Grimmsnarl, your opponent is running is going to be huge as well, because the last thing that you want to do is be on the wrong end of a trick. But looking at the accomplishment, as we talked about, Thiago coming from these ICs, this would be the accomplishment, the first one NAIC champion potentially to put under his name here. Christopher Hahn on the other end, a little bit of redemption as well. We can see a caucus regional finalist as well as a top four in Daytona. So close, but not able to quite get that victory, and you know that he's hungry for it today.
So either one of these trainers is gonna get their first title in the seniors division. And as we saw from Christopher's side, there is the Lunala Groudon team that is really supported well by both Venusaur and Charizard. It gives you, depending on the matchup, different avenues towards victory. If you think G-Max Vinelash is more important and also maybe some sleep powders, or if you want that raw sun boosted damage from G-Max Wildfire and Solar Power Charizard, that can be really hard. The issue though is the sun might not be up for very long if Thiago is able to use his Kyogre and Zapdos team effectively.
Yeah, control of the weather is absolutely huge, and it's gonna be imperative in this matchup. And Zapdos as well, it does directly counter and go up against both of these Pokemon. The Charizard is not going to appreciate a Max Lightning. Venusaur definitely doesn't like a Max Airstream whatsoever. Zapdos is a Pokemon that sometimes, once it gets into the right position out on the field, can be just impossible to be dealing with.
And if it is holding, or if it has Eerie Impulse, which is incredibly common at this point, like I would be surprised if Christopher is not expecting a potential Eerie Impulse into his Charizard slot there, or the Lunala slot also, because that could be really important there. Christopher has to be prepared for that outcome, because even if Zapdos is not able to knock things out, if you choose not to Dynamax it and you just want to lower your opponent's special attack damage output, well, Charizard, Lunala, and Venusaur are all sources of special attack damage on Christopher's side.
Yeah, definitely, but senior finals now, one step closer in finding out who is going to be our NAIC champion.
Looking at it with the Zapdos and Kyogre lead from Thiago, that is a very oppressive lead depending on what you want to go for. Zapdos is typically faster than a Kyogre, right? So if you want to target into that Lunala, you're gonna need to break the Shadow Shield. While Lunala has full HP, Shadow Shield, its ability, is going to reduce the damage taken. So if Zapdos can break the Lunala Shadow Shield, then a Kyogre Water Spout in the rain would be able to do its intended amount of damage, which to most people would be a lot. That's not a technical term, but it's a lot of damage. It's not a statistical term.
That is a great term of damage, but I mean, it is accurate. The Kyogre can be absolutely devastating, and Christopher recognizing that, instead going for a switch. Not only is the Lunala going to stay safe on this turn, but the Groudon bringing in the sun is a way to make sure that there is no rain boosted water spout, I mean, out. Now, it's going to be a Dynamax from Thiago's end here. Kyogre normally likes to go for the Origin Pulses or the Water Spouts, and Zapdos is a Pokemon that works so well with Dynamax, but instead, it will be the Kyogre. This is definitely a way to be dealing some damage. In the sun, it might be difficult, but you have the capability now to go for the Max Geysers and control the weather yourself.
Well, that's one way to reset the rain, and you're not even able to fake out because you attacked a Dynamax Pokemon.
The Eerie Impulse that you were talking about, the Groudon doesn't care about that at all. Now, as Christopher, you have that information. The Max Geyser to follow up, it's not going to be doing as much damage as it would normally do, but it's still going to be doing a lot. And now it's going to set the rain, and the Groudon can't reset it as it's already out on the field.
Yeah, that's the big problem for Christopher. He made a safe play by switching Lunala out and bringing Groudon in while the rain was up. That's like pretty much lesson number one in VGC, is if Kyogre's on the field with rain, bring Groudon in to get rid of it. But you were actually punished for it because Zapdos was not the Dynamaxer. He was anticipating Kyogre to just click Water Spout, but the Fake Out was essentially useless there besides that little amount of damage because it did. So Christopher put no pressure onto the field that turn. Now your Lunala's potentially at risk of taking a hit on the switch-in.
Especially as Zapdos is going to be firing off a Hurricane. Instead, though, into the Incineroar to finish this Pokemon off. Hurricane obviously much so appreciates the rain being able to be 100% accurate in this case. Now another Max Geyser. It does have the rain boost this time, but not going to be dealing as much damage because of the Shadow Shield.
Yeah, that's why Shadow Shield is one of the best Pokemon in the game. Lunala is definitely afraid of many of the attacks that are being thrown its way with the restricted Pokemon that can attack it. So now that it's down to half HP, another Max Geyser would be able to knock it out. If Christopher does not bring the Groudon in to somewhat neutralize it, it's still actually, you know, even in the rain, depending on how Lunala can be trained, you're not really too sure about that slot. But Venusaur is the reveal as Christopher's last Pokemon here, not bringing the Groudon right away. Instead, you could actually maybe try to have one of those cheese interactions with dynamic speed by switching Groudon in immediately, getting rid of the rain and activating Chlorophyll, and maybe putting this big Kyogre to sleep.
I don't even think that's cheese. I just think this is good Pokemon at this case. The Lunala is going to be leaving, and now the sun comes back out. Chlorophyll will be activated, and at this point, the Kyogre can't do as much damage, and it won't be able to do any at all because the Sleep Powder from this super speedy Venusaur will connect to make sure the last turn of Dynamax is wasted. The Hurricane in the sun, though, is going to connect. No Koba Berry, no Sash. Venusaur is gone.
That's only a 50% accurate move in the sun, so quite literally a 50-50 chance of Zapdos knocking out the Venusaur in one turn there. Christopher made a great call there by switching Groudon in, giving himself the sun boost for his Venusaur. I was thinking maybe even Kyogre might want to max guard to avoid the sleep powder, but it doesn't even matter at this point as Kyogre has earned a little nap as it's been able to get rid of two Pokemon.
I mean, at this point, too, Tiago's Pokemon, what damage have they taken? Kyogre taking a fake out damage as a Dynamax Pokemon. It's in such a great position right now that the Kyogre kind of deserving a little snooze.
Yeah, definitely in the Zapdos still at full health. Unless Groudon has access to like a Stone Edge or something and gets a critical hit into that slot, he's not necessarily too worried about it. You'd probably have to double target there. And of course, Groudon cannot click the Precipice Blades into the Zapdos, so you'd have to use something that does less damage. Tiago still not even revealing those last two Pokemon. You can switch Kyogre out if you want, just to ensure that you get the rain up later on, and then you know Christopher is never able to reset the weather at that point, and it looks like Incineroar is going to be the sacrifice into that slot.
Yeah, at this point, too, the fact that Christopher's down to the last two Pokemon, the Groudon is going to be intimidated, and that attack is going to be sticking like that for the rest of the battle, especially since Christopher hasn't gone for the Dynamax yet and is forced to at this position. It is now or never, as now this Groudon is going to have to put in the work, and already at negative one attack might be a little difficult. And I'm looking at the Lunala, too, at what it can do, because we know a lot of Lunalas have the Trick Room to maybe try and make sure speed's on the side, but no, Meteor Beam instead. We know that it has to be the Power Herb. There's no reason for it not to be the Power Herb. The one thing that might be a little scary at this point is a potential miss.
You could miss. You could also hit the wrong target because we want to see who Lunala is factoring in, the Zapdos or the Incineroar switch in. It's the Zapdos.
It is going to be the Zapdos, and it is going to be in a super effective hit to make sure the Zapdos is eliminated from the field. And now Christopher is trying to make sure this damage is done, but the Shulker Berry on the Incineroar is going to make sure this Max Quake isn't as effective as it would like to be. There's already the attack drop. There's the Shulker Berry. Incineroar is going to be plenty healthy through this.
Yeah, thanks to that berry, is actually staying well above half HP on the Incineroar. Now Tiago can either switch in the slumbering Kyogre or reveal your fourth Pokemon in this matchup. Lunala is at half health. The Groudon was safe to click Max Quake there because it's not like it was hitting the Kyogre super effectively anyway, and it was going to help you, giving both you and the Lunala, the Groudon and Lunala, special defense boosts whenever Kyogre switches back in. But for now, the sun is going to stay on the field as Zacian is revealed as Tiago's last Pokemon. It's, you know, very quick. It's not like there's any speed boost on Christopher's side, and Lunala with no Shadow Shield has to be wary of a Behemoth Blade.
Well, last awake Pokemon, the Kyogre, still taking a snooze in the back. still fairly healthy, but of course, once it comes back in, you're relying on those sleep rolls to see what can be done at that point. Zacian with the Protect right now, and we'll have to see how Crispr responds. It will be a Max Quake yet again. No Chocoberry now on the Incineroar, which means this is going to hit for a lot more damage, and Incineroar is gone. This is two Pokemon up against two Pokemon here in our first game of our Senior Finals.
And that is two special defense boosts as well for both of Christopher's Pokemon for when Tiago is forced to switch the Kyogre back in. But the Zacian is so fast, now it's going to move last.
Yeah, and this is going to be now a tricky situation for Tiago because the first part of the game was so ominous for him, making some great way, but we know with these Trick Room plays that that's the position that you're playing for. The Lunala now being able to twist the dimensions, you have to be so worried with Tiago because you've put yourself previously in a good situation, but now Kyogre's asleep. Both of these Pokemon have max health, but they have to be weathering the storm that's going to be thrown at them.
You have four turns of Trick Room to really take advantage of it, and if you have Trick Room on your team, you want your Groudon to be slower, and that is the case.
A big hit into the Zacian at this point with that Max Quake, and now a third special defense boost on to it. The situation getting a little more and more dire, especially the Kyogre not going to wake up. Now the Moongeist Beam from the Lunala. It can try and take out the Zacian or it can target and try and start dealing with this Kyogre, but no. 30 HP is all that's needed. Now Tiago only has one Pokemon left, and it hasn't done too much up to this point.
The double target into the Zacian slot was able to guarantee that if there was no Protect, right, you're able to knock out Zacian before it can get any attack, even if the Max Quake doesn't get the KO, just like we saw, which was key because the Intimidate made sure that the Max Quake was not enough onto the Zacian there. You're still securing its knocked out. You were kind of banking on Kyogre staying asleep a little bit there, but obviously you definitely can rely on that if you want to. And for Christopher, it could be a game-winning play.
It's going to be Protect, but it will be a miss from the Practice Blaze. And now the Kyogre waking up. Of course, it was Protect, but this move is going to be connecting. And we know that this is so powerful, especially in the rain. But that's where the special defense boost that this Groudon has been setting up are going to come into effect.
And on top of the assault vest there, that Groudon definitely just revealed by not even taking 50%. No, again?
Another opportunity for this Kyogre to put the damage in. And the Lunala, it doesn't have Protect this time. It's not going to take too much, but the damage is being done. And now it does have the chance to fire back a Moongeist Beam. But things getting a little scary, especially depending on how much this is going to fire off in return. About a third of the damage. You never want to trust in the orange in this situation. And press Mist Blades. Lunala now, the Protect, and it's gonna come down to what the Groudon can do. Two missed back to back, but it's gonna connect this time around. Can only miss so often. Kyogre now surviving. We'll have to see if it can connect. There it is.
It takes three Origin Pulses in the rain from a Kyogre to finally get rid of the Groudon. So now you are 1v1. Now you get the crit, if that's what Tiago is thinking. Could have got it on the last two times. Both these Pokemon really low. Twisted Dimensions return to normal. Lunala typically faster than Kyogre. That's what the Protect was for, to make sure that once you got out of Trick Room, you could outspeed and hit it with the Moongeist Beam.
And now the Lunala to finish things off here in our first match. Things getting a little scary to end things off, but the Kyogre is finally dealt with. Christopher to be taking the first match in the Seniors Finals.
What an incredible comeback from Christopher there, losing his first two Pokemon really quickly down in that Pokemon count for pretty much most of that battle. But because the Lunala was able to stick around after its Shadow Shield was broken, because his Groudon clicked Max Quake three times to get as tanky as possible against that Kyogre, he was able to withstand the damage output from Tiago's side there. And I just really, you know, cannot commend him enough for how he played his end game, because most people would get very nervous if you lost two of your Pokemon very early on in a matchup. For him to, you know, keep the composure and, you know, understanding your win condition is the +3 special defense on both Lunala and Groudon, and you can come back, and he did.
Yeah, Tiago at the beginning of that game was in such a strong position and so much damage being dealt, but the Kyogre going to sleep, and then all of a sudden later in the match when things started going a little bit more weird, the Trick Room being set, And you have to commend Christopher too, like you were saying, both staying calm, but the Groudon wasn't doing the most damage that you would typically expect from a Groudon because of the Intimidate from Incineroar on Tiago's end. So being able to play for that other win con of, okay, the max move does hit damage, but this setup might be more important, and it came down to that, though. Can't deny the Precipice Blades missing at the end too, back to back.
Yeah, that was pretty scary. Precipice Blades was turning into Precipice Pain real quick those last couple of turns when it missed so many times. The other key factor in that matchup was Trick Room being revealed on Lunala. Being able to twist the dimensions in this matchup against Zacian, Zapdos, Kyogre is probably trained pretty fast because you want those max airstreams to be beneficial. That Trick Room could potentially be the key to Christopher's success in a game two if Tiago is not prepared for it, has not made an adjustment for it.
And that is going to be a lead. The Lunala and the Groudon side by side going up against the Kyogre and this Zapdos. The Kyogre, though, setting the rain first, and now this means the Groudon also joining the field can set the sun right afterwards and essentially win that part of the weather war.
And that's obviously important because right away on turn zero, effectively, Tiago has lost the weather war, wanting to switch out Kyogre if you want to save it for later so you can get the rain back up in a better position against the Groudon. You do have to remember the Lunala has Meteor Beam, and if Zapdos does not Dynamax, that was a one-hit KO in the previous game. The Groudon, since it is Assault Vested, that gives you additional access to a fourth attack that is typically left for Rock Slide or Stone Edge. That's the one thing that usually gets left off of the fourth slot for a Protect if you're not running Assault Vest. But thanks to that, Groudon's held item, you have access to double Rock Attacks into Zapdos this turn. No switch.
No switch from either trainer, but it will be a Dynamax from Tiago's end. Last time we saw it was that Kyogre to make sure that the weather could be overridden, and it will be that one this time around. The Max Geyser in the sun, of course, not going to be the most damage that we've ever seen coming out from a Kyogre, but you might have lost the first part of the weather war, but you can try and make sure you can follow up. And no Trick Room, instead Lunala with the Meteor Beam. Of course, this being a one-turn attack because of the power herb, neither Pokemon would appreciate, but especially not that Zapdos.
Yeah, just like we saw in the previous game, if it goes into the Zapdos slot, which did not Dynamax again, could be disaster for Tiago.
And here it is. It is going to connect right into that Zapdos, and that is going to be a one-hit KO to eliminate it from the field starting off this second game. Now Tiago has to do the most work, and it's going to be starting with this Max Geyser hitting into the ground, bringing it down just under half health and setting the rain.
No Max Quake boost necessary on that turn for Groudon because he's still able to take that hit relatively well thanks to the Assault Vest and the sun being up at the time.
Yeah, and then a Precipice Blades, it will connect at this point and deal a good chunk of damage into the Kyogre, but no Trick Room now. The Zacian joining the field, it has the attack and it has the speed to start trying to deal some damage.
So Tiago opting to Dynamax Kyogre on that turn yet again in the sun instead of doing the natural VGC system of switching it out and switching it back in makes me think if he brought Zacian and Incineroar again as his backups like he did in game one, he didn't want anything to have to eat a Max Quake on the switch in. Incineroar would lose a Chikubari, and Zacian obviously is weak to the ground attack there. So you actually lost a considerable amount of damage because you clicked Max Geyser in the sun instead of switching it out. Luckily though, you do have the rain up now, and if you wanted to Max Geyser what was the Groudon, it's actually going to be the Incineroar, which would not want to take that hit either.
But swapping it in and then out means that's two turns that you're spending just trying to make sure the weather gets reset, and that gives the opportunity for the weather reset as well on Christopher's end. Protect from Lunala this turn around, but it will be a Behemoth Blade into that freshly swapped in Incineroar. Of course, that brought the Intimidate, it brought the Zacian to neutral, and Behemoth Blade not doing too much anyways. Now it's time to see where this Max Geyser is gonna go, right into the Protect of Lunala.
That was a safe play there from Tiago because no matter what, you're gonna break the Shadow Shield on Lunala, either doing a lot more damage or even just through the Protect. It doesn't matter, you still took 25% of that Max Geyser into that slot. Incineroar actually gets to stay on the field, yeah, pretty safely. Like if the Max Geyser was targeted towards that slot instead of the Lunala, would have been taking a lot more damage. And with that Intimidate, now Zacian's damage output has been hindered just a little bit there. And you have access to Fake Out as well if you don't want the Zacian to Behemoth Blade your Lunala.
That's exactly where that's going to be going. So Zacian not going to be able to do much, and this Kyogre going to have to do the most. The Max guys are now into the Incineroar slot, and it has no chance of holding on through that.
No, but that's fine, because now you get a free switch in to either the Venusaur or the Groudon, if that's what you want. You probably don't want Venusaur now that you just twisted the dimensions, though.
No, this is the perfect opportunity for the Groudon that we've already seen to be coming in, because it can deal the most damage. Zacian and Kyogre out on the field over on Tiago's end, and now the Kyogre only has that one turn left of Dynamax.
It has that end. You're going to have to match the Groudon that we have seen consistently be slower than the Kyogre at this point, so I wouldn't even think it is a potential speed tie. I think it's confirmed that Christopher's Groudon on this Trick Room team is definitely going to be moving before Kyogre. So one, you've lost some damage thanks to the sun coming back out, thanks to Groudon's Drought ability, but he's also going to be able to get a Max Quake onto either slot. You know, kind of doesn't even care because, all right, maybe Zacian protects and you don't do a lot, but you still get the plus one special defense. Or you attack the Kyogre, get the boost, and you're bringing the Kyogre down to be low enough to get knocked out by Moongeist Beam. It's really tough. Whatever slot Christopher wants to go for is definitely safe. And including Incineroar doesn't want a Max Quake either.
Yeah, Incineroar coming in place of the Kyogre. Of course, the attack drop onto the Groudon going to be effective at this point. Groudon, interesting to note as well, doesn't have too much HP, so we will see a Dynamax here, but that's something to keep in mind, that it doesn't have that full bulk and force that it did have over in game one, and because of that, it'll be the Max Lunala making an appearance.
Yeah, Lunala wants that double HP at this point instead of the Groudon. Remember in game one, Groudon was full HP when it maxed, like you were saying, so it's a little riskier to do it, and maybe you just want to hit both targets, maybe if Precious Plates connects this time.
Yeah, and it will. The Shuka Berry, of course, on the Incineroar to protect it from a good amount of damage, but the Zacian's not going to be so lucky, bringing it right down into the yellow. And now the Max Rockfall from the Lunala to hit into the Zacian's lot, and that is going to make sure it is gone.
That's the special attack boost coming in clutch from the previous turns where he got it thanks to activating the power herb from the Meteor Beam onto the Zapdos. So something that happened turn one is proving critical later on in this matchup. That's why he wanted to Dynamax Lunala, so you don't have to wait two turns to click your rock attack there. And now that Zacian is down, Tiago is down to his final two Pokemon. Christopher still does have the access to pivot if he wants to get rid of the Groudon on this turn, or switch it out so you can bring it back later to get rid of the rain.
This is a tricky situation as well, because there's still three more turns of Trick Room. Sure, you might have the weather that you would like with the Kyogre, but now the Incineroar, the Flare Blitzes that maybe you could have used as a possibility to try and deal some damage back, is not going to be nearly as effective that you need it to, and you don't really have the speed on your side either with the Kyogre to do too much damage. It needs to be weathering what's being thrown its way. Incineroar not going for damage, instead that parting shot onto the Lunala to make sure it can at least be back at neutral going into this turn, but another round of Precipice Blades. The RNG that it lacked last turn, it doesn't this time around. It connects onto both targets.
He's gonna need crits.
The hit, a critical, no critical hit. And that means 5 HP left on the opposing end. Now Max Rockfall fired back into the Incineroar, didn't need to do much.
Yeah, by not clicking a Dark Attack like a Throat Chop or Darkest Lariat, that really pretty much reveals Tiago did not have a Dark Attack that could hit the Lunala for a 4-time super effective hit, and that's going to cost him here as the sand is going to start ticking down on the rest of the Kyogre's health. And if you just keep clicking Water Spell at 52 HP, that's not going to be helpful, but a huge survive by the Groudon as well to hang on through that attack.
Yeah, at that point, it wouldn't have mattered. There was such a lead already. And Christopher is going to be your seniors NAIC champion, taking it down 2-0.
That is now the U.S. 2-for-2 so far today in VGC. Congratulations to Christopher. Really well played, waiting for the right turn. Didn't just Dynamax right away in either of these games.
Thank you very much, guys. And let's start with a big congratulations, Christopher, on becoming the seniors division champion. Coming off that win, yeah, look at that, they're loving it. How are you feeling coming off that win? How are you feeling coming off of that win?
I'm feeling great. It's my first international, and it was a really hard top four match to get here.
So a hard top four match turned into a pretty comfortable looking final matchup. You went 2-0 in that one. The team, something not everyone was looking at. Did you get any inspiration for this team building when you were looking at what to bring here in Columbus?
Yeah, actually. My friend Kylan sent it to me. Mm-hmm.
And you just ran with it, tested it, see what happens?
Yeah.
Well, it's worked out really well for you. The one thing we noticed watching the game, in game number one, you played a really nice Trick Room end game. How important has that been, like, throughout the top four and the finals as well?
I generally saw myself using Trick Room a lot because it helps with Pokemon like Zacian, who are obviously doing a lot to my Groudon and my Lunala. And when the Zacian's at full, there's not a lot I can do against it, especially if they have Incineroar or other Pokemon with Intimidate. So it was generally pretty useful.
It seemed that you got a lot of value out of it, but in game two, you pivoted over to Dynamax the Lunala instead. Is that something you've been doing a lot, and do you feel that gives you just another option in these matchups?
I believe the only time I Dynamax Lunala this tournament was also in my top four match. It was also to hit an Incineroar, so, you know.
Well, it seemed to have worked out really well for you. Once again, let's hear it for Christopher, your seniors division champion. One more final to go, so we're going to take a short break and then be back with the Masters division.